Welcome to Dansplaining Video. I'm going to show you how to use Davinci Resolve to draw a line that appears to track a moving object. So first, let's create a new project. I'm going to call it the Arc 3. And then right click here to import media. I have a short video clip that is down here. It's a 720p because my MacBook Pro is too old to be able to handle a larger video in DaVinci Resolve. It'll ask if you change the project frame rate. Click change. We'll drag the video clip to the timeline. Now we need to create a duplicate layer of this video clip to draw our line. So to do that, we're going to go over to the Edit tab. And then I don't need the audio with this, so I'm going to get rid of it by right-clicking on the clip, uncheck linked clips, and then left-click on this gray background to deselect both pieces, then right-click on the video and hit the delete key. Now to duplicate this video on the Mac, you hold down the Option key and drag. I think on a PC, you hold the Alt key down while you drag. So now my clip is duplicated. Okay, now I'm going to create my line by going to the Fusion tab. Now I don't need to see these clips here, so I'm going to go up here and click on Clips to hide those clips. Now to draw the line, I need to start with a background. And I drag the background down to this line. And then just to tidy things up a little bit, move the background node up above the merge node. Now this black background is going to be our line. And I'm going to change the color to red. And then I'm going to use a mask to mask out everything except our line. And to do that, I'm going to use a B-spline. And as soon as I select the B-spline, that background is hidden. So I guess I'm actually using the B-spline mask to show part of that background. By default, the mode is click append, which means every time you click, it adds to the B-spline. And by default, the automatic keyframes are enabled. So down here where it says right click here for shape animation, I'm going to click on that red diamond to make it gray because I do not want keyframes created for this step. Now over here on the far left, I grab this little line and scrub the video to get to the point just before the motion starts. And I want to scrub all the way through the motion to get an idea of where I need to draw the arc. So I'm going to go right back here to where the movement starts. I'm using the B-spline is selected. The default tool is click append, which is what I want. And I'm just start clicking to draw the B-spline. And then over here on the right, I'm going to increase the border width a little bit so you can see the line better. And that's our line. And then here we just scrub the video, move the playhead to make sure that the line is where we want it. It's not quite in the right place at the end. I'm going to drag the individual nodes and adjust them a little bit. You can even change the mode of the B-spline tool to insert and modify. If you do that, then when you click on an existing node, you're moving it, you can move it. If you click in between nodes, it actually creates a new node. So you can create as many new nodes as you need to get the line to look exactly the way you want and adjust the existing nodes as much as you want. Like that to be a little bit higher here. And for demonstration purposes, this is good enough. If you were doing this for your own purposes, you might want to spend more time getting it to be exactly the way you want it. But now we're done with this step. Now what we need to do is create a mask that will hide this line and then animate the mask to reveal the line as the hand sweeps from one place to the next. We're going to do that on the color tab. Down on the bottom, click on the color tab. And depending on what you've been using DaVinci Resolve for up to this point, this window will look very different from this. There are all these different tools related to color correction and color grading, but we're not going to use any of those. We're going to use the window mode. And if keyframes, if you're not seeing the keyframe tool, you just click on this control here. And you need to see the nodes. So if the nodes are not visible, need to click the nodes up here. And actually, we don't need the gallery. So the first thing we need to do is create a alpha channel, which will make the, so what creates the transparency. We need to mask out the top layer by making it transparent so the bottom layer will show through. So we add alpha output, right click in this background, select alpha, add alpha output, and that created this little rounded rectangle with the cyan dot in it. Blue to cyan, anyway. Then click on this blue square and drag a line and connect it to that this node that we created. So now that creates our alpha channel for us. Then we need to come down here to the keyframes tool and next to corrector one, click this gray diamond so that it's red. That turns on automatic keyframes. And I just remembered we don't want to do that yet. So the next thing we want to do is come down here to draw the mask, and there are different tools. Square, a circle, and so on. We want the pen tool to draw a mask freeform by just selecting control points for the mask. And then we need to click on this box to invert the mask. And I'm going to draw the mask. As we go, I think it'll become obvious why I'm drawing the mask in the shape I am, but I'm going to start with a point here in about the center of the circle that would include this arc, and then put a couple of control points near the beginning of the line and up near the top right, top left, bottom left, and then join the bottom left to that center dot. And you can see the line disappeared because we've masked it out. If I invert it, we can see it. Actually, if I uninvert it, we can see it. If I invert it, it's gone. Now we want to turn on the automatic creation of keyframes. We do that here with the keyframe tool where it says corrector 1. Click on that gray diamond so that it becomes red. So that when it's when that diamond is red, we're in the mode of automatic keyframe creation. And then to create the first keyframe, we just need to move any dot and the keyframe automatically gets created on the frame where we were when we moved that dot. So now we're ready to start the animation by moving ahead a few frames and then move the dots to reveal the line, and then scrub backwards a little bit to make sure the line is where you want it to be, and it's not where I want it to be. I want it to look like it's trailing the hand. So I just adjust that a little bit until it looks the way I want. And when that looks the way I want, then I continue ahead a few frames and do the same thing. Move those control points, scrub back to make sure that the line is where I want it to be. And then just keep going. Move the control points. Scrub back to check that the line is where you want it to be. And you just keep doing that. Moving forward. And then when you get to the end of the motion, one last time. I'm gonna move that. And this last part, every time I've done this, the last part of it always, the line trails the hand farther than I'd like. Okay. So we're done with that. The next, and it looks good. So just to check it out, I'm going to go back to the Edit tab. And scrub back and forth through this video to make sure it looks the way I want it to. And it does. So that is how you can draw a line in DaVinci Resolve and make it appear that the line is tracking a moving object. If you liked this video or found it helpful, tap thumbs up. If you didn't like this video and didn't find it helpful, tap thumbs down with a really big hammer.